The Philippines confirmed 4,289 new COVID-19 infections today, bringing the total number of active cases to over 47,500, the lowest since March 14 this year. 164 more patients have died, while around 6,000 more people have recovered from the disease. In a monitoring report released by the Octo Research Group, Davao City still tops the list of areas with the highest average daily cases outside the capital region. Using risk classification of COVID Act Now, which was developed by the Harvard Global Health Institute and other groups, it turns out Davao City is high risk for some indicators like infection or reproduction number, incidence or average daily attack rate, and testing or positivity rate. ICU utilization is at very high risk. Risk levels for different indicators vary for every area. For the National Capital Region, indicators are at low and moderate risk. Nationally, the average daily attack rate is at moderate risk, ICU utilization rate at low risk, but positivity rate is high. The World Health Organization has earlier reminded the health department to be more cautious in saying that the country is already low risk for COVID-19.
Siguro mali din talaga yung framing ng communication natin na yung low risk na yung bansa. But there was no intent for DOH to pronounce or announce that, you know, the Philippines is at low risk and we can be complacent already.
Verhere also explains that the Octa Group and DOH use different metrics.
We're trying to correct yung misinterpretation based on this factual information na binigay ng DOH. Pero katulad nga ng sabi namin, kailangan ma-analyze natin at maintindihan ng ating mga kababayan ang pagtingin ng mga datos na ito. We just don't look at the national aggregate, but we need to look at the disaggregated numbers or data from the different areas of the country.
Meanwhile, the Octo Research Group says the high vaccination rate in the NCR may very well lead to something good in a few months.
The NCR has received 29% of single doses, and each LGU has vaccinated between 20% to 70% of their population one dose, which suggests that a month from now, or a month and a half from now, that will be fully vaccinated people. And so, yes, the data suggests that in a few months, the NCR particularly may be Delta resilient. And if this is the case, this is good news for the country.
While the DOH welcomes the statement, it reiterates that there is no place for complacency, especially with the Delta variant. The DOH reminds the public on the importance of getting the second dose of the vaccine to ensure full protection. Studies have already shown that a fully vaccinated individual has lesser chances of being hospitalized or even die after infection from the Delta variant. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.